Welcome to the next class on digital marketing. In this session, we will learn a brief about Google Ads. Let us start with the overview of Google Ads. So Google Ads is an advertising platform by Google. So Google Ads allows businesses to display ads on Google search results and partner websites. That simply means whenever you search for something on Google, the first few results will be as ad or it will be sponsored. Those kind of things can be done with the help of Google Ads. We will understand how to do it practically. Let us understand the theoretical part, then we will also do the practical part. Google Ads also provides multiple advertising options such as search ads, display ads, and video ads as well. We will discuss more about the types of ads once we reach different types of Google Ads here. Now let us understand what is the benefits of using Google Ads. Wide audience reach with access to billions of users. When we give ad on Google, the entire world can view our ad, or we can give the ad for the entire world to see that. Targeted advertising options based on demographics, interests, and behavior. We can target customers on their age, gender, location, what are their interests, as well as their behavior. Cost effective with control over budget and bidding strategies. That simply means you can decide what is the budget of your ad. You can set your own budget. Now let us understand how does Google Ads work. Advertisers create campaigns and ad groups. Whenever we give ads on Google, that will be called as campaigns as well as ad groups. Now let us understand this when we do it practically. The next thing is choose keyword and create ad copies. Now, if you remember, we have learned about Google Keyword Planner, where we use certain set of keywords and then we will add it for our SEO part. Along with SEO, we can also use those high quality keywords in our ad as well. We can use the exact match, broad match, phrase match as well. We can also set bidding strategies and budget. We can set a bid for a keyword and we can also set our budget. Ads are displayed based on relevancy, quality score, and bidding. So once we start giving an ad, Google Ads will help us to realize what is the strength of our ad. Is it average? Is it incomplete? Or is it good? The next thing that we have is targeting options in Google Ads. Let us understand this. We have different types of targeting: location targeting, demographic targeting, interest targeting, remarketing, custom intent audience. Let me explain each thing one by one. So location-based targeting is nothing but we can target specific countries, regions, cities, or even radius around a particular location. For example, if I am staying at a place with the pin code 56219, I can give my ad on that particular pin code as well. I can give the ad for entire country, or I can even give ad for a certain region or even a city. I can give the ad in Bangalore, Pune, Delhi, Mumbai, Ladakh, any city. The next thing that we have is demographic targeting. Target based on age, gender, household income, parental status, etc. We can target our audience, or we can target the customers based on their gender, based on their household income, based on their age as well. Now we have interest-based targeting. Target users based on their interests, hobbies, or specific topics. So if I am a writer, so I can give an ad for people who are interested in reading books. Next thing that we have is remarketing. Target users who have interacted with your website or app before. Now, for example, if you have a website or an app, a user have visited your app or website once or twice, you can retarget them. Next thing which we have is custom intent audience. Target users based on their recent search behavior. That simply means if you have searched something on Amazon or Flipkart, you will see the same kind of product or the similar products everywhere on all the social media platforms which you go, or even on Google Ads as well. That is called as custom intent audience. You might have seen this. When you search for a cell phone on Flipkart, you'll get these ads everywhere. That is called as custom intent audience. Now, the next thing that you have is different types of Google ads. We have search ads, display ads, video ads, as well as shopping ads. Now, let us start with search ads. Search ads are text-based ads displayed on Google search results page. You can bid on keywords related to your business. If you search for digital marketing agency in Bangalore, digital marketing is a keyword, and the first few results will be Google search ads. That is the text-based ads. Next thing that we have is display ads. Display ads are nothing but banner, images, or text ads displayed on websites, apps, and videos. You can also target a specific placement or interest. When you visit a website, there will be a slight or little box on the right-hand side of the search that will be called as a display ad. We will understand all these things better when we do it practically. It might be a bit confusing while learning the theoretical part. Be patient until or unless you learn it practically. Don't perform the active Google ads, or don't give the ad. Don't lose your hard-earned money. Understand this, then start with it. Next thing that we have is video ads. Now, ads displayed on YouTube and other video platforms. These options include skippable, non-skippable, and bumper ads. Now, when you play a video on YouTube, you might have seen number of ads which has skip ad, or the ad will be played for more than 10-12 seconds. You can't skip that ad. You can also give those kind of ads with the help of Google Ads as well. Next thing that we have is shopping ads. Product-based ads displayed on Google search results. It showcases product information, images, and prices. If you run an e-commerce business, you can give the product ad as well. Now let us understand the best practices for Google Ads. Continuous testing and optimization, regular monitoring and adjustments, stay relevant and up to date. Let us understand each thing one by one. You can try different ad variations, landing pages, and targeting options. So for one single ad, you can try a different set of variations. You can try different landing pages, and you can try various targeting options. Iterate and improve based on performance insights. That simply means if your ad's runtime is more than a week, you will see the insights of the ad. How is it performing? Based on those insights, you can update the ad, you can change the locations, you can change the demographics, you can change keywords. That is what is called as improvement based on performance insights. Now, the next thing that we have is regular monitoring and adjustments. Now you have to stay updated on campaign performance and make the necessary adjustments. That means if your ad is running on a regular basis, and if you need to do some improvement or some adjustments in that ad, you can even do that. You can even optimize bids, budgets, and targeting to maximize results. So if your ad budget is 500 rupees, you can increase the budget, or else you can decrease the budget. Now we have stay relevant and up to date. That means keep up with industry trends and changes in Google Ads policies. Now, Google Ads also have some policies that we have to follow. These policies will be changed, or it will be getting updated on a regular basis. Stay updated on those things. Adapt strategies to align with evolving user behavior and technology. Now let us understand tracking and measuring success in Google Ads. Now we have conversion-based tracking, Google Analytics integration, performance metrics. Let us start with conversion tracking. You can set up conversion tracking to measure actions on your website, track conversions like purchase, form submissions, or newsletter signups. That means if a user visits your site, if he or she makes a purchase, you will be notified that one lead has been converted into a customer. And if you run an e-commerce business, you can see what is the number of purchase. And if you have a contact form on your website, you will also see how many people have signed up for your contact form. The next thing is Google Analytics integration. Connect Google Ads with Google Analytics for more detailed insights. Analyze user behavior, traffic sources, and conversion path. Now, when you connect your Google Analytics account with Google Ads account, you get all these details. If you don't know how to connect Google AdSense with Google Analytics, click on the I button. I have made a video on it. Click it, link both of your accounts. You'll get all these details. The next one is performance metrics. Monitor and analyze metrics like click-through rate, conversion rate, and cost per click. You might have already known this. What is click-through rate, conversion rate, and cost per click? For example, if I have a budget of 1,000 rupees for one click, what is the percentage of amount Google have charged? If it is 0.68 rupees, the cost per click is 0.68. Make data-driven optimization based on the performance data. So based on the data which you get after the ad has been run for a while, you can optimize those ads with the help of certain keywords or different types of targeting. Now we have optimization strategies for Google Ads. We have keyword optimization, ad copy optimization, landing page optimization, and bidding optimization. Let us start with keyword optimization. Research and select relevant keywords. Use match types effectively to control keyword targeting. Now, you all know we have used Google Keyword Planner to research for the keywords. Use those keywords in your ad as well. Apart from that, we have learned about exact match, phrase match, as well as broad match. We can use those keywords while giving ads as well. Now we have ad copy optimization. Write compelling and relevant ad copies. Experiment with different variations. This simply means if you are giving an ad on Google, make 3 or 4 different copies so that you can check each ad individually. Like, how is it working? You can check that out. Now we have landing page optimization. Create landing pages that align with your ad copy and offer clear value. Optimize for speed and mobile friendliness. As you all know, our website has to be responsive on both cell phone as well as laptop and desktop. Now, if you don't know what is a landing page, I'll be listing one of the landing pages in the comment section. You can check that out. The last thing that we have is bidding optimization. Monitor and adjust bids based on performance. Utilize bidding strategies like target CPA or ROAS. So based on the performance of our ad, we can change our bid and we can use some bidding strategies like targeting cost per acquisition. Like, to acquire one customer, what is our cost? As well as ROAS, that is return on ad spent. If I have spent somewhere around 7,000 rupees for the ad, and if I generate close to 9,000 rupees, so my return on ad spent is 2000 rupees. So this was the theoretical part of Google Ads. In the upcoming videos, we will learn it practically.